Hey guys, welcome back, and I have another sketchbook tour video. This one I started at the end of last year, like literally the last week, and yeah, I finished it yesterday. So I just thought I'd do some little sort of sprite designs on this with the metallic markers that Hit Art sent me, Christina. So yeah, let's get started. So you'll recognize this piece, I hope, anyway. This one I did for my first 2017 piece of work, or video, that was showing art. Yeah, I really like starting off my sketchbooks with a piece that I'm proud of, so I thought I'd do this one because I love drawing horn girls and I really wanted to see what it'd be like doing, like, I was going for like the ram sort of style. Yeah, I really like this piece. I don't know why I'm just flipping the book like that. Let's just do that. This one is the piece that I coloured in for my watercolour brush markers review thing. And again, horns. The Mark Curly challenge. That was a fun challenge to do. Kind of frustrating that I couldn't do more in 10 seconds. I think I'll do this challenge again. But maybe in a few months' time after I've been drawing a bit more. And I'm hoping, because I've only took a month to finish this sketchbook, I'm hoping I can do more, like get at least one a month done maybe. There'll be a lot of sketchbooks at the end of the year, but this was my left hand challenge. And it turned out better than I thought, so that's pretty good. This one, spoiler alert for a lot of these, by the way, because I'm doing, as some of you might know from Claire's channel, I'm doing the fan art video every day in February of fan art with Black Summer Colouring. She's doing it as well. I'm not sure whether I'm going to do this one in that or not. I think I've recorded the sketching process. But this was actually done because I was planning on doing the screen cap redraw, but it's kind of out of proportion because this book is actually a little bit smaller than A4. I mean, this is an A4 book and you can see the difference. So I don't think I'll get one of these sketchbooks again. This is just a cheap one from the works. I'm not sure how much they were. It was actually a Mother's Day gift last year, so that's nice enough anyway. It's good enough for just doing quick sketches in like this. But yeah, this is Yuri on Ice, as some of you may have guessed by the yes, the naked man. This was my draw it again challenge picture, the original sketch. I actually ripped the pages out and just kind of taped them back in or stick them back in after I've finished them. Just that way I'm using both sides of the page and making the most out of all of the paper. And this one is from my draw with Jazza entry for the competition of the month. The Legendary Axe. This was my first concept sketch, and then this was my final concept sketch before I went on to doing digital work. I was planning on doing a piece for Chinese New Year, and it's the year of the rooster this year, so I was using my different brush pens to practice writing rooster, and that one was my Kuretake brush pen. Where are they? Here. Yeah, that was this one, the Kuretake. And this one was the Micron brush pen. I'm not too keen on this brush pen. It's, I don't know, the bristles are quite, oh, I don't mind if you can call me. I don't think I've used it enough and I've not used it on decent enough paper properly. So I think I'll just wait and try and use it a bit more before I do proper judgment on it. And then these ones were just my Pentel brush pen. This one, yeah. I was thinking of going down like a masquerade sort of idea, so either like having a girl, because I did originally want to incorporate horns in some way, but you can't really incorporate horns with a rooster in a way that it would look good, so I thought like a masquerade mask would be quite cool. And yeah, these are just some of the concept sketches for it. I really liked how the mask turned out on that one, but not her, because her face is a little bit out of proportion for what I was going for, and I didn't like the way the arm turned out either. Yeah, these are just my little swatches for my watercolour brush pens. Some more Yuri on Ice things, which this is a spoiler for one of the videos. for February, and I'm actually doing something different with this video than just showing you the drawing process, so look out for that one. More Yuri on Ice. I thought I'd try and do a little chibi, because I don't really draw them very well, or very much. So I thought with these, I'd try and draw them. I'm alright, like doing faces, I'm not too bad. I'm quite comfortable doing that, but when it comes to drawing bodies, I struggle. I don't know why, I just want to draw it in perfect anatomy, but you can't do that, so it just feels wrong, and they don't turn out okay. This one is, well, kind of self-explanatory. I really enjoyed watching Yuri on Ice. I know loads of people are like, they don't like it or anything like that, but I enjoyed watching it, so I thought I'd do a bit of fan art for it. Totoro, My Neighbour Totoro. I was just trying to draw from memory. I didn't have a reference photo for any of these, so I thought I'd try and draw from memory, and again, just using, this one was my Pentel brush pen. And same with these, I just thought I'd do quick little brush pen doodles with it, and just trying to come up with ideas for a Totoro piece. And this was more of the concepts for my new Chinese New Year piece. I liked where this one was going. You can't really see it very much, but let's see. Sorry for the squeaky chair. Yeah, this is where I was trying to incorporate a horn. But this is the list, because I did ask online on a few different social medias if you had any requests for what fan art you wanted me to do. Let's hide that one. Yes. You can't see that one. You can't see it. Yes. This one was following the same idea as this sketch. I was going down the horn route for the Chinese New Year piece, and I really like how this sketch turned out. She's going to be like wearing a kimono and looking at a like a rooster feather thing, and this horn would be red, but it didn't quite give the theme of the piece away, if you get what I mean, so I haven't really done much with that. Spoiler alert again, one of my other pieces for Fan Art Feb, which you'll see me do this full piece in markers, which killed a lot of them, so I hope you guys like that, because I need to buy new markers because of this piece. I actually did some emergency commissions. They're still going now, actually. You just need to email me and I'll leave my email down below. But yeah, I'm just doing sketches for £5, line art £10, and a full colour A5 illustration for £15. It's just to help me cover costs of moving house, because we've still not moved yet, sadly, and hoping by the end of February we'll have moved, hopefully. But and I was going to do a sale as well, but I haven't got around to doing that yet, and just little to-do lists. This was one of the commissions. It was from my friend Charlie. She loves Orphan Black, and she's come up with her own characters to go along with it. So there's Rachel and her character, which I can't remember the name, but yeah. These are some concepts for my piece that I wanted to do for Your Lie in April fan art. Most of this sketchbook is fan art stuff for Fan Art February. Spoiler, Peridot. Which, this will be the first video going up, so if you love Steven Universe and you like Peridot, then please go and check it out. But on the 1st of February, this will be the video that you'll see doing this one. So, yeah. More Your Lie in April stuff. I like that part of this sketch, the piano on this sketch, and so I used my light box and traced that part onto some separate paper, and then I redrew Kao, I think her name was, Kari, something like that anyway, but I redrew her on a separate sheet. Just, I ended up doing the whole piece in three different pieces. Now Claire, this is a bit of a spoiler one for you. One of the fan art pieces I'm doing is, I'm doing some of them based on my favourite YouTubers, and this is like a character stylized version of Claire and Laura, so I hope you like it. I thought I'd combine the two channels, because you're both, well, you're both on YouTube and enjoy YouTube, and so I thought I'd do you both in the little YouTube button with Mervin? I'm sorry if I got the name wrong. Marvin, something along those lines. I'm sorry, but his character design was so cute, and I thought I had to incorporate him. Though, if you are wondering who Laura is, her channel name is Project Unicorn, and I'll leave her link down below. It's a lovely channel. She gives some really great advice and talking about her sort of experiences with things, and she's just a really nice, and she's a really bubbly person to the camera as well. So, this one is a humanized version of Jigglypuff. I thought I'd do the little tattoo there. You probably won't be able to see this one very well. I wanted to do a Leia fan art. Now, as some of you will know, my daughter is actually called Leia, after Princess Leia from Star Wars, because my husband is a big Star Wars fan, and I just love the name anyway. But I really wanted to draw her. That's just on one of the programs. I want to try and start using some notes on that. But this, I'm really happy with how this sketch turned out. And I'm actually, when we have finally moved house and I can get my acrylics out again, excuse me, I want to do her as a full acrylic painting. I'm thinking like flowers in the background and stuff. And when I've got a recording set up ready to go for doing recording acrylic paintings as well, because I'll definitely record doing this for you. So if you want to see me paint this at some point, please subscribe and keep a lookout for that on my channel. Hopefully it'll be soon. This was the first concept sketch I did for a Harley Quinn design, and I was trying to combine like the different sort of outfits that she has in all the different versions of her. So there's like the daddy's little monster top and the baseball jacket, and then I think they're the trousers from one of the games where she's got the black and red leather trousers, and she is wearing the corset sort of top. But I thought I'd try and do those, but I really didn't like how this turned out. The proportions were all wrong and the head was too small, and yeah. These were some of the thumbnail sketches, colouring things for my Spirited Away piece. So, more spoilers. You're so lucky today, you are getting all these spoilers. I'm not going to say what that one's for. That one's a secret, and you'll find out. You have to keep an eye on my channel and watch my videos for Fan Art Feb, and you'll find out about this one. This was a sketch I was doing for an Attack on Titan piece, but I like the direction it's going, but I don't like how the sketch is turning out, so I'm going to redo this sketch. Harry Potter sketch. This is the roll out Tippex, because I didn't like how I went over the mouth with my fine liner, so I just used Tippex and then drew over it. I know it's naughty, but oh well. This was going to be an Inori piece from Guilty Crown, Yuzuriha Inori. But again, I don't like how the face turned out, and yeah, so I kind of just left that one. My Totoro piece, this just gives like everything away. Again, it's the Tippexy thing. But yeah, this is another one. This, my husband wanted to draw a picture in my sketchbook for me to colour. There's me thinking he was going to do something like, I don't know, a face, or he has this thing for drawing like ant farms or tanks. So I thought he was going to do something like that, but no, he just did loads of doodles and I had to colour them. So I thought, you know what, I'm just going to pick three markers at random and just whatever. Use it as a way to vent and just not even concentrate properly on it. So that's what that is. Big Hero 6 piece that I've done for Fan Art Feb. I'm not going to tell you what I've done that in, just so you might actually watch it and find out. Just some sketches. I am like super proud of how this eye turned out. It's probably like one of my better eye drawings. Yeah. And it was just in Biro, which I've not used just Biro for a long time. And that was just another Biro character sort of sketch. To be fair, it was just a doodle because I was just getting so creatively numb. Like, because I was just doing fan art and it's just like, yeah, or I was trying to draw them in my style, like Harry Potter and stuff, and coming up with like different compositions, but it's not the same as drawing your own characters out and having to come up with a whole piece from scratch. So I just needed to try and draw something that was like not based off of something else, so without any reference photos or anything like that. I mean, this was no reference photos, this is just from memory. I was actually helping my husband fill out some paperwork, and I drew that while he was talking about something. So yeah, this is my final Harley Quinn sketch, which I'm yet to colour her, so I haven't decided what medium I'm going to do her in yet. That sounded really bad. What medium I'm going to colour her in? That sounds better. But yeah, I went with the hot pants from the Suicide Squad design, and I really liked the curly hair, which I don't like how some of these curls turned out, but I'm not very good at drawing curls, to be honest. I need to practice that. And then from the game design, I believe it was, there was the tight corset bust top thing and spiked shoulders, and the collar was from one of them, I don't remember which. But then on the trousers on her, the Jester character design, she had like these four diamond shapes, so I wanted to do this as like a tattoo. I'm giving everything away now. This is a list of what sketches I've already done and what challenges I've done so far for the fan art feb. So let's just like go over that quickly. Now this was actually more fun to draw than I thought it was going to be, because I normally draw people, and I mean I've drawn some characters, but my go-to thing is drawing human anatomy and stuff. I've never really done like monster character design, and I don't know the name of it. It's one of the creatures, like character design creatures from Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild, and I just liked how the character was designed, and I thought, you know what, this is going to be a good challenge for me, because yes, it follows some proportions of human anatomy, but it then changes them to make this character, and it was so much fun. It was a little challenging to draw because, again, I wanted to do like the legs longer and stuff like that, so I did have to use the reference photo for this quite a lot and like make sure, just keep checking back on it. But I'm super happy with how, and I think I might try and actually make some of my own little monsters like this at some point, because it'd be quite interesting. If I could just draw men's bodies just like how I've drawn this one. I know men don't look like this, but then I might actually like not struggle. And the final drawing, yep, of the book is a lapis drawing from Steven Universe. I haven't done anything with this sketch. I'm just not sure whether I want to use it or not, because I think the position's too stiff. I think I'd probably get more of a flow in her body position. So, yeah, more such sprites. But that is my sketchbook from January in 2017. I'm hoping I can finish a sketchbook a month, or at least a sketchbook for every 2 months, that sort of thing. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see how it goes. I think the only reason I've managed to fill this one so quick is because of doing Fan Art February stuff. Because I've got to get 28 drawings done, and I'd rather keep ahead if I can, so I'm not falling behind on uploading every day. So yeah, that's kind of pushed me to draw more. But it's getting me in a good habit, like Inktober does. That gets you in a good habit as well, of drawing every day. But I think a sketch a day is something I definitely want to try and do, and maybe one day work up to doing like a 365 day project of literally a sketch a day. One that is not like a crappy little thing that I'm not going to use, but a like these sort of sketches. So they could be full illustrations. I know there is going to be some little ones in there that aren't complete, or that I can't use, or that are terrible, but try and get on that one page or something, maybe a full one that I could turn into a full illustration. Because if you have a creative block where you can't think of something to draw, if you've got something like this that's full of sketches, then you've already got the idea there. I mean, like my Princess Leia piece, wherever that's gone, the idea for that is already down, and I can just use that to. If I don't like feel like I can create a new image that day, I know for a fact that my muscle memory and my skills, I would be able to redraw this onto a canvas and paint it. But it's not coming up with a new concept, it's just already there, so I can do it. So I'm still creating something, but I've got the idea there to just push myself to get out of that creative block. Because you find when you start doing a piece, then you start to feel better and ideas start to come to you. At least that's what I find anyway. If I'm struggling to come up with a new piece, all I have to do is sit down and colour or paint something I've already drawn, and then I start to get ideas for new things, either linked to that one or something like that. Like if I'm painting the Princess Leia one, I might come up with a design for doing a Chewbacca one. But then after that's an idea that's come into your head that you wouldn't have had before, so you can move on. But yeah. Anyway, that's it for this video. I'm sorry I didn't post one on Monday. I've actually had a lot going on this past week. I've actually started having panic attacks, which I haven't had. I had them in my pregnancy, but that was pregnancy related. So I haven't really had them since school. So yeah, I've been dealing with that. But luckily, I've had no more for the last, well, the rest of this week since the weekend. I've not had any. So hopefully that's it and they won't come back now because they're horrible. And I have no idea what set them off either. Probably because of all the stress with moving house. But anyway, I'm fine now and I'm back to creating. I've been sketching the whole time, even though I've been having them just as a break, but I haven't been able to get any videos done because I just couldn't bring myself to do it and it might not work or something. So I'm sorry about that. But this Friday's video is going to be my art school experience video, so I hope you look forward to that. And I will see you on Friday. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and see you Friday.
Day has passed.